They both live in eastern Kentucky, and they want to be your next state treasurer. Democrat Rick Nelson is a state representative from Middlesboro. Republican Allison Ball is an attorney from Prestonsburg. We'll talk about their backgrounds and goals if elected tonight on Issues and Answers, the Mountain Edition.
Issues and Answers, the Mountain Edition, is sponsored by the City of Hazard. Come home to the mountains.
Rick Nelson and Allison Ball are our guests tonight. Rick will be joining us in about 15 minutes, but ladies first. Allison, thank you for being here today.
Glad to be here.
Well, this is the state treasurer's race, and it's an Eastern Kentucky affair this year. First, for folks who don't know a lot about you, just tell me about your background.
Sure. Well, I'm from Prestonsburg, like you mentioned a little bit ago. My family's been there for 9 generations since the 1790s,
wow.
So a long, long time. I'm related to about half the county. And I'm a bankruptcy attorney, and I practice in Pike County over in Pikeville.
Yeah.
With a buddy of mine from law school, we opened a practice together, and that's where I do my day job.
How old are you? You look very young.
I'm 34. I'm older than I look, but yes, I am young.
Yeah, younger than me. So why do you want to be state treasurer at such a young age?
Well, it's a great question. You know, I am a bankruptcy attorney. So what I do all the time is I think about getting people out of debt and getting people on sound financial footing. And I've always cared about the state of our Commonwealth, always cared about helping politically. And so, you know, helping people individually as a bankruptcy attorney, I thought I wanted to use those skills to make a difference in Frankfort, help our state get on good, sound financial footing. I was a prosecutor for 4 years, and when you've done that, you also start to care about people and how to help. So that background just spurred in me a desire to make a difference, and I decided to run for Kentucky State Treasurer.
Well, what do you think makes you better qualified than your opponent?
Well, I am a bankruptcy attorney,
yeah.
So I've got a financial background. I think that's important for the Office of Treasurer. Like I just said, I think all the time about getting people out of debt, getting people on sound financial footing. I like to fix financial problems, and that's something I enjoy, I think about. So I want to use those skills in that Office of Treasurer. The Treasurer is supposed to be a watchdog position. Having been a prosecutor for 4 years, you learn how to develop a backbone, which you need to be that watchdog on our spending.
You are a Republican. Are you supporting all the other statewide Republicans in the election?
Well, you know, I am supporting all the Republicans because I do think that as a slate, we do have the best vision for Kentucky right now. But that's independent of me. I think I've got so many friends who are Democrats who will be voting for other people on the slate who are supporting me because they understand that we need somebody with a financial background in that office. I've got a lot of friends, of course, who are Democrats from across Eastern Kentucky who are supporting me just because I think what's important is the person. That is the most important thing, is who is best qualified for that position. And I think somebody with a financial background is the most qualified.
What's going to be the key for you to win?
Well, that's a great question. I think just getting a message out, Kentucky is poised for a lot of good things. But I think we've been making the wrong decisions in Frankfort, particularly when it comes to economics. So I want to encourage people and help people see that there is a good future for Kentucky, even for Eastern Kentucky. And a lot of that has to do with finances. A lot of that has to do with economics. So I want people to understand that there is hope for our area, hope for the state, and I want to make a difference in that.
I read that you've been handling finances since you were 9 years old.
That's true.
Tell me about Positive Pencils International.
Okay, I sure will. Well, you have done your homework. When I was 9, I like to tell people that's where I got my understanding of business and hard work.
Mm-hmm.
Because when I was 9, I got an allowance. I got $5 a week, $20 a month, and I felt like my life was set. I was very comfortable. Things were exactly the way I wanted them to be. And at that point in time, true story, my mom and dad came up to me and they said, Allison, we decided to stop giving you allowance because you're learning how to depend upon other people for everything and you're not learning how to work hard. You're not being responsible. So they cut off my allowance. And I had a terrible attitude about this at first. I was upset. But then eventually I came to the point where I realized that my mom and dad were serious. And if I ever wanted to buy toys or go to the movies or do anything again, I'd have to figure out some way to earn money. So, 9 years old, I started a business. I started Positive Pencils International. I was thinking very big, and I designed pencils that had different positive sayings on them, like, I'm a winner, believe in yourself, you can do it. Sold them for 25 cents each, or for a dollar. So it was a great deal, and that first week that I started my pencil business, I sold pencils to everyone I could. So, you know, Steve, if you'd been around me that time when I was 9 years old, you would have bought at least a dollar's worth of pencils. And by the time that week was over, I made $200. And I thought, oh my goodness, my mom and dad were right. And I tell people, I became a believer in free enterprise, in business, in hard work, all those great principles that we as Kentuckians believe in from that moment on. And I think that's important too for the Office of Treasurer, to have appreciation for hard work, appreciation for business. And I want to bring that to the table as state treasurer.
So what are your main goals if elected?
Well, that's a great question. You know, this is a watchdog position. Mm-hmm. So my number one goal is to do the job the way it's supposed to be a watchdog on our state money, our taxpayer funds. It's been sort of a rubber stamp position for a long time. And I think it's important that it is an independent position, independent from the governor, independent from the General Assembly, actually being accountable to the people, making sure our money is going where it's supposed to, where it's appropriated. So that's the number one thing I want to do. I do have a desire to increase transparency. I think that's important. I think that is a good watchdog role. Ohio has done a spectacular job on transparency. They've got a website called ohiocheckbook.com where you can look at everything having to do with state finances. And I'd like to have something like that in Kentucky. I think that would be good for us. And I also see this as a platform position for good economic policies, working with the General Assembly. The state treasurer is the chief financial officer, so nobody knows better what money is coming in and what money is going out. It would put me in an excellent position to be an advocate for good financial policy. I think it'd be a great position for advocacy for tax reform, for pro-middle class policies, things to stimulate the economy, things that stimulate Eastern Kentucky. So those are things that I care about and want to do straight off the bat.
Well, I'll ask you about one hot topic right
sure.
now. Some Republicans have called on the state auditor and treasurer to investigate and audit the Cabinet for Health and Family Services to find out the amount of taxpayer dollars going to Planned Parenthood.
Mm-hmm.
Would you support that?
Well, I think that would probably be a good thing for taxpayers to know. That is an issue that means a lot to a lot of Kentuckians. And we want to know where our taxpayer dollars are going. That's something that should be, that's transparency right there. That should be an easy thing for the government to respond to and provide that information to taxpayers, because people care about that issue. I care about that issue.
Pension reform is another big issue in the governor's race for sure. How can the state treasurer get involved in that and help that situation?
Well, and that is a great question. And actually, I should have mentioned that when I was telling you the things that I care about, because that is a top, top issue, particularly since the treasurer sits in the Kentucky Teachers Retirement System Board.
Mm-hmm.
And everybody knows that it is in serious shape. It needs somebody, I think, with a financial background, keeping an eye on it. You know, that is it's a minor aspect of the treasurer's office. The treasurer's office is much broader than that, but it is an important aspect. And I want to be a voice on that board for long-term fixes, for sound financial decisions. So I want to make a difference. I think one of the ways that I can make a difference is transparency, shining light, providing information to people that are involved in the system. We have a contractual obligation to those teachers. They don't get Social Security. They need somebody looking out for them. So I am excited about being able to be a voice for transparency, a voice for sound financial policy. I'm mindful of the fact that real changes are going to have to come from the General Assembly. So some of my role would be an advocacy position. But there is a place for the treasurer on that board. And as also just an advocacy position, you can also have some impact on the other pension systems as well.
Mm-hmm. Do you have any ambitions of eventually running for a higher office if you're elected?
You know, I've got one focus right now, and that is to be state treasurer and to do a good job in that office, to use my skills for that. So that is the only thing that I'm thinking about right now.
Can you cite specifics about how you can help Eastern Kentucky specifically as
well, sure.
state treasurer?
Sure. I mean, I think, you know, we just talked about teachers. There are a lot of teachers in Eastern Kentucky. So I think that is an area that would have a direct impact on our area. You know, teachers are the backbone of the whole Commonwealth, but they're particularly a backbone for Eastern Kentucky. Education is the key for anybody being a success in their life. So that is an area of direct implication for where we're from. And of course, you know, getting the state on sound financial footing, that's going to help Eastern Kentucky. You know, being a bankruptcy attorney in Pike County, I see very clearly how Obama's policies have affected Eastern Kentucky, how it affects the coal industry, and I want to be a voice for the coal industry, a pushback against liberal policies that are hurting people in our area. So I want people in our area to know, especially the coal industry, that you're going to have a friend in the treasurer's office if I'm there.
Of the 38 states that elect a treasurer, I understand Kentucky pays its treasurer more than 31 of them. Would you consider reducing your salary?
You know, and that's fine with me. I think one of the perspectives, though, about that is that all the statewide constitutional offices get the same salary. So it's actually not based on what are you getting in this state as it compares to Kentucky. It's not a balance from state to state. It's just statewide officers get a certain amount. And I'm a big believer in limited government and being efficient with state funds. So, you know, I'm always open to streamlining things and figuring out what is the best way to use taxpayer dollars. And sure, I'm of course open to that.
Well, there was also talk back in the primary, I think one candidate supported actually abolishing the office of state treasurer. Tell us why you think it's important.
Well, let me tell you one thing about that person's position, because I think people didn't quite understand it. This is a constitutional position. It comes from the Constitution. So it cannot be eliminated or abolished by whoever holds the office. The only way it can be modified is through actually amending the Constitution itself. You'd have to do that through getting a majority in the state Senate, a majority in the state House, and then the people of Kentucky would actually have to vote on it on a general election year, which I think has to be an even year. So it's not even an easy process, and it's not something whoever holds the office can actually accomplish himself or herself. So I think that's an important perspective for people when they hear people talking about that. So I think that's important. I am eager to do the job the way it was intended, to fulfill that constitutional obligation. And I think that that's what my role is right now, do the job the way it's supposed to be done.
The outgoing state treasurer has been aggressive trying to find the owners of unclaimed property. Mm-hmm. He's been around the state doing that. Would you continue that effort?
Absolutely. As a believer in property rights, I want people's property to be returned to them. I don't want the government holding on to money or items that don't belong to it. So yes, I'm a big proponent of getting those things back to people. I want to see that.
How would you grade Todd Hollenbach's performance as treasurer?
Well, you know, the story is that he's not in the office enough. And I think that's important to be in the office. And that's one of the things I want to be doing. I want to make a difference. I want to make sure it's not a rubber stamp. I want to make sure that I am acting as a watchdog. So, you know, he's not running again. This is an open seat. It's not really about him. It's about doing the job. And I want to do the job.
Well, I only have a minute or so left, so I'll give you the final word and to address voters and why they should pick you.
Sure. Well, again, I think it comes back to I'm a bankruptcy attorney. I think about debt. I think about financial problems. I think about financial fixes. And that's what you need in the office of treasurer. Having been a prosecutor, I've got that backbone to be a watchdog. I want to use both of those things. And as an Eastern Kentuckian, I want to look out for our area too.
All right. Allison Ball.
Thank you.
We appreciate it.
Thanks. Glad to be here.
And we will be right back with State Representative Rick Nelson after this. State Representative Rick Nelson joining us now. Rick, good to see you.
Thank you, sir.
First of all, for folks not really familiar with you, just tell me a little bit about your background. And we were just talking, you've done all sorts of things.
Well, we have. I was born in Harlan County, Kentucky, in a coal camp called Black Star. My father was an underground coal miner for over 30 years until he was injured in the mines. I went to Bell County High School, Cumberland College, and Eastern Kentucky University. Mm-hmm. Been married 39 years to the same woman, and we have one daughter. My basic career is in education. I started teaching in 1976, retired in 2005, and as you and I were talking, we broadcast ball games on the radio for over 30 years, close to 35. As a matter of fact, we had the privilege of doing a game with Neil Middleton and Tony Turner. They got me to call one of the games, and they did the color for it. So I remember that very well.
Wow. Well, how long have you been state representative?
I was elected in 2000 and started in 2001.
Okay. So why did you decide to run for state treasurer?
State treasurer is a good challenge to help a large number of citizens. And I've always been in public service. I know that sometimes people that are elected are called politicians. I prefer the term elected official. It depends on how you use that title that you have. And I think giving back to the community and the citizens is what it's all about. Of course, this is on a bigger scale, being the state treasurer. But as we will talk, I guess, in a few moments, it has several jobs that really affect a lot of our Kentucky citizens.
Mm-hmm. What do you think makes you better qualified than your opponent?
Well, I'm not saying neither one of us is qualified, but I think there's two things. I think, first of all, I think life experience and job experience. And, of course, I am the oldest candidate at 61 running, so I guess life experience, obviously you would have more. But a classroom teacher for 29 years, I think everything that we do as we go through life, the good things and the bad things, makes us better prepared to face a crisis or a challenge. As far as a professional career in the General Assembly, Steve, we do multi-billion, $20 and $30 billion budgets every 2 years. So we're aware of the money situation, and I think we do the best that we can with the money that we have. So I think that experience that we have in the state government, I think that helps us a little bit.
Are you supporting all the other statewide Democrats in November?
Yes, I think, and I've got to know a couple of them. Couple of them I didn't know personally. I think it's a good ticket. I think they're for the citizens of Kentucky, and very much so.
How do you think your experience as a state representative and a teacher could help you as treasurer?
Well, I think the first thing you're going to do when you go into that office on January the 5th or 6th is, first of all, you're going to have a $3.1 million operating budget. You're going to be the boss or the coach, however you want to say it, the leader, over 33 employees. And every dime that comes into Kentucky and every dime that goes out goes through the treasurer's office. So you have to have someone with some management skills, some people skills, and again, I go back to our legislative experience with some money skills.
What would be your main goals if elected?
Well, number one, job one is to keep an eye on the checkbook, mm-hmm. to make sure it's balanced. The treasurer has the ability, if they feel that there is a bill comes through, they don't have to pay that. They can always red flag it and refer it to the auditor. That is number one. But Steve, also the treasurer has a lot of other activities, which I think is important. And I don't know how you rate them after that number one. But first of all, the treasurer sits on the Kentucky Teachers Retirement Board. I think it would be a big deal to have a retired teacher on that board. There's about 140,000 either retired teachers or active teachers in that system. And they're going through some hard times like all the pension systems are. Number two, it's unclaimed property. Every year, about $45 million in unclaimed property comes through the treasurer's office. Most of it is found by the treasurer, and they look for a Kentucky citizen that is the owner of that property. And Todd Hollenbeck is giving out about $20 to $25 million. The rest of it is put away with the name of the folks on it in case they're found later. Also, there's the Keys program, and most people that are watching this are familiar with that. It's where your student, your high school student earns money due to the grade point average and test results. And that money is actually the Kentucky Lottery. Furnishes that. There's 125,000 students that gets $236 million every year through the Keys program, and the Kentucky treasurer sits on that board. And another thing I would like to highlight, it's part of the treasurer's duty, but it's not been very prominent, it's financial literacy. And I want to push the financial literacy part. I think we need to educate our high school students on money management. We have a lot of bankruptcies and a lot of foreclosures now. And I'm not saying financial literacy being taught in school or highlighted by the treasurer would cure all that. But I believe in education, and I think it would be a big deal for the Kentucky treasurer to highlight that.
I want to ask you about a hot topic right now. Some Republicans have called on the state auditor and treasurer to investigate and audit the Cabinet for Health and Family Services to find out the amount of taxpayer dollars going to Planned Parenthood, which has been a source of controversy nationwide for months. Would you support that?
I don't see nothing wrong with it. My understanding is all their money comes from the federal government. So maybe some questions should be directed to the federal government too on why that money's coming out if they think it's a problem. Mm-hmm. But if I'm not mistaken, Steve, it's almost $500 million that comes from Washington, D.C. To Kentucky, and most of that is for Medicaid reimbursements. So I have no problem with that. I guess what they're trying to find out is if any of the taxpayer money is used for abortions, and it's not supposed to be. So I don't have no problem with an investigation.
If you're elected, do you have any ambitions of eventually seeking a higher office?
No, I do not. I think that, at 61, I don't think I'm necessarily over the hill. I've got a lot of energy, and I've traveled probably 35 or 40,000 miles since the election started, and I think I can keep up with the young folks if you consider 61 old. But no, I want to, if I'm fortunate enough to get elected, Steve, I want to do this to the best of my ability like I have all the other jobs that I've had, and I have no aspirations of going any higher.
How could you specifically help folks here in Eastern Kentucky as state treasurer?
Well, we've already mentioned some of that. I think if the treasurer goes in, of course, you know, on day one, you have to go in and see if you need to make any changes. I don't believe in going in the first or second day and just firing everybody or making changes. You've got to see what's working and what's not. But I believe in Eastern Kentucky, and I was born here and raised here. And when you talk about retired teachers worrying about, is their pension going to be there? Of course, there's 22 years left on the system. It's the teachers teaching now that we're worried about. So we have Eastern Kentucky teachers. When you have students in Eastern Kentucky and colleges, you know, it goes up every year. I think it's a big deal to make sure that when they earn money in good faith in high school, that money is there for them in college. So you help Eastern Kentucky as treasurer like you would help anyone else in any other part of the area.
Do you feel like you could do more as state treasurer as you've done as state representative?
Well, I guess it depends on who you talk to and what we've done for state representative. But, you know, our average winning percentage is over 70. And, you know, I guess most folks would take that. So I feel that the citizens are satisfied with what we've done. But I believe you can always do more. And it would be my goal, for example, on the financial literacy. Steve, I would like to go to every high school as part of my duties, not the only duty, but part of it, and teach a class in financial literacy. I think it would be a big deal to have a constitutional officer come in and do that, and I feel I did that for 29 years, so I feel comfortable doing it. I think also it's called Treasure Finders through the Unclaimed Property. I would like to take that program to each county because we have, I believe, $300 million that's out in unclaimed property that belongs to a Kentuckian. Now, I don't want to stay in Frankfort staying behind a computer. With electronic world we live in today, you know, you can monitor things and you have staff that does it. I think I want to get out where the folks are and let them know we're doing our job. And I think if you get out to the counties, I think you can do a better job as, for example, the unclaimed property. And that's just the way I feel about it.
I read that of the 38 states that elect a treasurer, Kentucky pays its treasurer more than 31 of them. Would you consider reducing your salary if elected?
Well, I will make this pledge, and I believe it's 100. I don't even know what it is exactly. It's probably over. It's the same as the attorney general and right. the governor and the rest of them. Since I want to get out a lot, and there may be some question if the funding is there to pay the expenses of going out. You know, if the funding is not there, I won't care a bit to pay my own gas and expenses to go out to teach financial literacy and take the treasure finders. I don't care a bit to do that. But I think Governor Beshear asked the cabinet maybe 4 or 5 years ago to take a voluntary 10% pay cut. I have no problem with that.
There's even been talk back in the primary, I believe, a candidate supported abolishing the
right.
office of state treasurer. Why do you think it's still important?
Here's why that would be a bad idea. Let's say that you're the governor and you appoint me as your treasurer. And I must be a friend or a supporter if you have done that for me. And if I'm non-elected, Steve, let's say unclaimed property, $45 million comes in, $25 million goes out. And what if you come up and say, Rick, we're in a tight budget this year. Instead of you doing $25 million, let's just do $5 million. The rest of it goes into general fund for later. And if you're my boss, I have to do that or suffer the consequences. But if I'm an independently elected state treasurer, I can say, Governor, I'm sorry about that. My job is to find Kentucky citizens that this money belongs to. And I think accountability is the main thing why that the treasurer should not be appointed.
How would you grade Todd Hollenbeck's performances?
Todd, I think he gets an A, and here's why. He does the job. Now, Todd is not flashy. One of the budget cuts he did, he decided not to have a person that does press releases for him. Mm-hmm. So they're kind of on their own on that. Todd just does his work. He does it well, but it's not flashy. Now, the last couple of days, and you followed this case, I'm sure, on the unclaimed property, he returned a check to a gentleman for $410,000 who bought 20 shares of Apple stock about 20 years ago, forgot about it, and Todd found him and presented him a check for $410,000. Todd's doing a good job. He just does not promote himself. So,
since you're a state representative, I'll ask you this. What's going to be the biggest issue coming up in the next legislative session?
Well, one of the things that we're going to have to do is going to be on our pensions to make sure that we have enough money to pay the ARC on those pensions. We had a bill Speaker Stumbo presented, House Bill 4 last year, that would have given a little bit more money to the teachers' retirement system. And I voted for that bill. And they were going to use that in a variety of ways. And because we were not able to do that, we were downgraded by one of the bond agencies, I think by maybe from an A to an A minus or something. And they specifically said that was the reason. So we had a plan that was not only going to help the teachers' retirement, but it was also going to help the state of Kentucky, because it was going to allow the state of Kentucky to fund the ARC at a lower rate for 7 years. Next year, it's going to be about $500 million to fund the ARC. If we had passed Speaker Stumbo's bill, it would have been $44 million. So I think that's going to be the biggest issue. Money's always the issue. Mm-hmm. And it's been pretty tight. Governor Beshears had to cut, I think, $2 billion out of the budget since he's been in. And Steve, we had to borrow $1 billion to pay unemployment benefits. And we've got that paid back 7 years ahead of time.
Do you agree with the decision not to call a special session for the Kim Davis situation?
Well, every time we call special sessions, we always get criticized because of the amount of money. I think that's played out so far. The General Assembly can do something when they come up in January if that's what they want. I guess he was trying to save money. If he had called it, I would have went, naturally. In fact, I went a couple special sessions and I've not taken money for that. And I would have been glad to do that this time.
Just a few seconds left, so I'll give you the final word. Why should folks pick you here in a few weeks?
Well, and I thank you for this opportunity, Steve. I believe and I'm hoping that folks will pick me because of my Eastern Kentucky background, since we're going out through East Kentucky. I'm a 29-year school teacher. I think that helps. I have a lot of life experience. I've paid a mortgage. I've paid my bills. I've paid car payments. I've borrowed money for my daughter's college and paid it back. So I think from a personal standpoint, that gives me some experience. And then again, as state representative, every 2 years we vote on a multi-billion-dollar budget. So I know about the money matters as well. So I'm hoping that'll be enough, and would like to ask for their vote and consideration this November.
All right, State Representative Rick Nelson.
Thank you, Steve.
Appreciate it. And thank you for joining us. We'll see you next time on Issues and Answers, The Mountain Edition.